everybody, welcome to PROlike Gear, where we make builds for your set looking and working like professional products, but being inexpensive. My name is Herman Kaltenbach, and once again I'm very proud to present you a new episode. Before we start, I have to admit that I'm very happy about your feedback, about your comments, the number of views I got the last month. Thank you very much so far, and if you get any topics I should cover, just leave them in the comments below. Thank you very much. So let's go on! Last week I saw an adapter out on the internet that gives you the possibility to connect your headphones to your DSLR or video camera without having a headphone jacket. Sound great! When you're recording your audio through the camera, this is definitely a must-have for every filmmaker. But there was a little hitch. The price, something like $45 to spend. A lot of money for such a small adapter, so check out this. A homemade version for 3.5 euros at all. The principle is very simple, it's just a 3.5mm jack to the audio RCA adapters from your camera. So let's go directly into building process. I bought two 3.5mm jacks and a 3.5mm headphone jack on stereo RCA adapter at my local hardware store. Also I found a short cable, 3 wires at minimum, lying around. So I could build a connection between the two 3.5mm jacks. I think for some more money you could also buy the finished cable, but I decided to solder it myself. I simply connected the 3 wires on the one side to the one on the other side and attached the jackets. Finished. 5 minutes of soldering. And my soldering skills are very bad. So now we can plug our RCA adapter to our 3.5mm cable, and with this we can connect the RCA output of our camera to headphone jackets. That was the technical part. With these steps you already saved around $40. If you are using a Canon DSLR camera, like I do, you may already notice that the display turns off if you are connecting to RCA adapter. Well, to disable this feature, we have to install Magic Lantern firmware. Magic Lantern firmware gives you endless possibilities, like having a real film camera. It's definitely a must install, and so check out how to do it. I'm using my T2i or 550D for this demonstration, but the install routine is the same on the other Canons as well. By the way, this is no official Canon firmware. It's something like an add-on for it, so you are doing this on your own risk. Today, the procedure is very simple. First, we have to download the newest Magic Lantern firmware to our computer and extract the folder. Then we place a fully charged Canon battery into our camera. This is very important. Next step is to format a simple SD card in the camera, going to menu and format. And also you have to clear settings, like picture styles. Now we plug the SD card into our PC using a card reader and copy the whole folder of the Magic Lantern firmware into the main folder of the card. Then we switch the camera to manual mode and put in our SD card. We boot the camera, go again to menu and enable firmware update. And a few seconds later, you can see the green success screen. So reboot it, and Magic Lantern is now running and can be accessed over the trash bin button. Well, that's already everything. Magic Lantern is now running from your SD card on your camera. It's not installed on the camera. So if you are using Magic Lantern, you have to use the SD card. If you want to uninstall it, you just have to go again to the firmware update button and go through the instructions. Then you can delete the files on the card. Don't delete just the files on the card. You always have to go through the firmware update first. So this new firmware has a lot of new functions. A lot of them I never touched before, so I think I could cover a whole episode with it, if you're interested. But for the way right now, I just want to show you how you disable the monitoring turn-off for your camera. We hit the trash bin button and switch to the audio menu. There we can enable the function monitoring USB. With this settings, we can use our headphones during viewing the LCD, a great and important function. To just give you an overview what's also possible, you have functions like focus peaking, which means that image parts that are in focus are marked. Also changing the ISO rate is much easier and detailed with the Magic Lantern firmware. Or you can add in-camera letterbox for choosing the right aspect ratio you want to edit with. And of course, you can enable the visual leveling of your internal audio and also turn off the HEC control. So a lot of functions, a lot of possibilities. Check them out for yourself. We see us again in the next episode. Thank you very much. Follow me on Twitter, twitter.com/JKProduktion, JKProduktion written with a K, or subscribe to the channel. Thank you and goodbye.